Well, the judge in the case, the Authors Guild versus Hathi Trust, basically ruled entirely in favor of Hathi Trust and the constituent libraries, including the University of Michigan Library, which I direct.
What was the issue? What were you being sued over?
We were being sued over making unauthorized copies of copyrighted works and, making those copies, having those copies, and using those copies.
And why were you doing that?
We were doing that because we find enormous value in allowing full-text search of works. And full-text search is very different from being able to read works. We do not permit our users to be able to read any works that we have that are in copyright but not authorized for us to have copies of. But you can do full-text search, so you can search the library's works and determine what it is that you want to read. It tells you what page number a given phrase would be on. Then you go to the library or you go buy the book or whatever it is to do that work. So that's one area. The second area that's extremely important is accessibility to the print disabled. When we have digital files of these works, we can then use those files in order to turn text to voice or in order to produce very much larger text that people can read. There's lots of very good software that makes it possible to use things that way, and that is something that we have done for our registered students. Again, we believe this to be a transformative use and a valuable use of these works. And we also have a preservation copy of these works because lots of print works are rotting in various ways. Many of them are printed on acid paper. They get old, they get lost. And because we have these, we're able to make a second copy if there isn't one available in the marketplace, if the circumstances warrant it. So all of those reasons, the judge said, yes, that's consistent with copyright law, and so now we can go back to being what we want to be, which is a library. Actually, we've been a library all along, doing a better and better job of ordering, organizing these works, making it possible to do full-text search, and serving the interests of the scholarly community at large, of print-disabled people, and of our campus.
And long-term effect of this?
Well, I think assuming that the ruling stands and, these things can be appealed, and I don't know what will happen in the future, but assuming that the interpretation of the copyright law that Judge Baer adduced in reaching these decisions stands, the implication is that the mechanism of full-text search, which is so valuable to scholars who are trying to find what it is that is most important for them to read, will stand, will be expanded, will be used more and more. The ability to do linguistic research on the corpus of data that is constituted by the words in these texts, that kind of work will happen more and more, and the ability to produce accessible versions of things for the print disabled. All of these things, which are very natural for libraries and universities to want to do, will be able to be done, not just by us, but by any library, by any entity that is serving the various communities. And I think that the work that these communities do is extremely valuable. We have believed all along that what we were doing was consistent with the law. We wouldn't be doing it if we didn't think it was consistent with the law and with the fundamental purpose of copyright, which is to promote progress of science and the useful arts. That is what we're up to.
Getting a little constitutional on this.
Yep.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.